when I spit like this. Loving when I spit my shit. This nigga wanna record when I'm rapping this shit. Yeah. Feel me now, listen. Yo, blood of a king, heart of a champ, old soul. My mind militant, diligent with the workload. Rigorous regiment, committed to excellence. Versus varsity level, I could never be freshman 10. Tight writer, sniper, tight lion, tiger. Bear with me, it's real tricky trying to describe us. Yin yang in its physical, hard like Ving Rhames in his physical. Plus I bring brains to the interviews. Things changed, I'm a different dude. See, I got shit to lose, but I ain't doing shit to lose. Get your life cut short like an interlude. Think it's something sweet, gotta miss the screw. Champion sound.
So that's how champion sound dog?
Yes, sir. Side champion sound.
Yeah, yo, yeah. Hold on, why I don't got no bars on that?
I mean, the remix is available, my boy, so when you ready, I'm ready.
We he said, what'd you say? Type lion, tiger.
Typewriter, sniper.
But bear with me. I saw that tiger, lion, bear. I heard it in there. I be peeping bars. I know how I rap a little bit.
Yeah, nah, I know. I know you know how
I
rap.
I know how I rap a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. I'm a lyrical demon out here. Niggas just don't know that. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a dickhead. Because I'm a dickhead.
Welcome, welcome, y'all, to the show, the podcast. We are here. We are lit. We are having fun on this fucking coronavirus. I forgot. Whatever the fuck it is. Welcome, y'all. My name's DJ Chelsea Lee, and this is DevNasty. He gonna start it off for y'all.
What up, what up, what up? DevNasty, a.k.a. Dangerous DevNasty. Today, I have a couple special guests. I have three special guests. We have next to me, well, let's just jump right to the nigga that you just heard rapping, man. This is AudioOnly. You know, Camden, you know, lyricist. Super lyricist.
Yeah, thanks, bro. Appreciate that.
Comes from a legendary sperm background. He does. He does. You know, his grandfather.
This is the best introduction I've ever
had. I'm just saying his grandfather is the legendary Jersey Joe Walcott. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, so when he talk about how a champion.
Statue coming soon.
We talking about legendary shit.
Real Rocky story. No made up shit.
Yeah, real shit. Yeah. And you just blew that down, man. You know what I'm saying? That made me want to, next Joan, I might come in rapping and some shit. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
And to the left of me is a celebrity. Once again, I don't even know why he's back on here. and it's the boy, funny boy Quill 215 zone, right? 215 or is it 267?
No, 215.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
I don't know. Same shit.
What's the difference?
Yeah, what is the difference?
I don't know.
It's a 5 and not a 7. What the fuck are you talking about? It's like, no, it's 215 though. You know
all right, it's always gonna be 215. Yeah. That's what it is.
Like it's 267, like a different. I'm asking, bro, this is a real question.
That's for like the cell phones though. You get a 267 on a cell phone. The house phones is 215.
You can't get a cell phone with a 215?
That's how that works.
I mean, you can, but I'm saying on a house phone tip, that's you don't start from the 215.
So when you say 215, where you from?
The 215?
Mm-hmm.
North Philly area, to be exact.
Cool. Hey, that's what I want to know, bro.
He said
267 for other niggas.
Yeah.
267 for Northeast.
So is that how you disrespect a nigga? Is you tell him, like, use a 267? Is that how you do it?
No, I don't do it like that, but you can.
Yep. Yeah, see, that's what I... All right. I wanted to hear that.
Yeah, because we don't know, because we from Jersey, so we used to all be 609, and then it switched over to 856 for some of us. So that's why we said that. We kind of miss being 609.
I don't even pick up for 609 numbers.
Damn. That's like a North Jersey nigga now, right?
That's like a North Jersey nigga.
That's a North Jersey nigga. It's totally different.
Would it be anybody?
Yeah, it's totally different. But in the middle squeezed in right there is none other than toe-sucking legend.
Whoa.
Legend. Freak boy. Yo, this nigga right here, this is one of the original Nasty Boys, the freak boy, super creative. You know, this is the man behind the song Dumps that you might hear sometimes when you see the girls out here twerking and all of that.
Whoa.
This is none other than Bodega Vega, a.k.a. Leonardo Vega.
What up?
Yo, you got like a superhero real name. Like, that's fire.
Do you know what pisses me off though? Where like Jones be like, you're a Ninja Turtle. It's like, come on, man.
Oh no, because of the Leonardo. Your name Leonardo Vega though. That shit like fire,
yeah,
nigga.
It's fire. I didn't like my name when I was younger, and until I was older, I was like,
Leonardo Vega. Nah,
I mean, I got a long list of like Leonardo Vegas in my family. Like my dad's Leonardo Vega.
Oh yeah, and your dad.
My grandpa.
I know your dad, so he's not to be proud of. I know that nigga.
My grandpa's Leonardo Vega.
Oh okay.
his other son's Leonardo. It's just too much Leonardo Vegas and shit. And they not the best people.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about being named after somebody? I never understood that when he'd be like, John V, John VI. What if your dad, like, not to say you, but in general, dad was a serial killer or a murderer named after them? Like,
I got
how does that make you feel?
I was at the I don't know, the precinct, jail, whatever, one time, and the cop came up to me and pulled, because of my name, didn't know anything about me, was like, is this your dad? And showed me a picture of my father, and it was just like, oh, criminal
shit. You already know his rap sheet is disgusting.
So, at first it was horrible, but now it's just like, I make a name for myself. This is my name.
Okay. Yeah, he didn't do all that shit that the other Leonardo Vega did, which we will talk about on some other episodes. We won't talk about that, but this nigga's legendary in the hood. But right now, man, it's crazy. Like, we still underneath this coronavirus shit, man. And the thing that's real crazy, me and Paula was talking about, man, recently, is like, chicks is acting really, really different on the gram right now, dog.
It's ugly out here, man.
What's your timeline looking like, Paulo? Like,
man, it's ass and milk and motherfucking
milk.
Oh, milk.
Yeah, they pouring milk on your ass.
Is it whole milk or 2%?
All different type of shit. Oat milk.
Oat.
Almond milk.
shit stale and all that coming out the bottle. Nobody got time for that.
Let's get to that.
I don't understand it, though.
They just... twerking away.
Yeah, for the Cash App.
Yeah, so this Cash App thing is what... So you think the Cash App is what got them really turned up, Quill?
Yeah.
Cash App.
Oh, then no. Girls been twerking for the Cash App. They was twerking on the gram before they was getting money.
Yeah, they took it to a new level.
They was twerking.
Now they like, oh, you gonna give me some money? Okay, I'll put hot sauce on my butt.
But right now, it don't seem like my timeline got so much filthier. Like, it's to the point where... people that you wouldn't normally see doing shit like, yo, you're a politician. Like, what are you doing? Like, why are you twerking right now on that
nurses
level?
And all that, right. Yeah.
But it's like, it's not a regular twerk. A regular twerk is cool.
Yeah.
But when you pour milk chocolate and shit like that, it's like taking it to another level. Because you got to think that milk chocolate is going
through
the ball.
You know what I think it is? You know what I think it is? Why you saying that? I think it's because, see, the bitches ain't get, I can say bitches, right?
Yeah.
Oh, we can say bitches.
The bitches. The
say
bitches.
Whatever you want.
Oh, bitches. Nah, this is what it is. This is what it is. They,
bitch.
Everybody.
That's on you.
Nah, everybody quarantined, right? So the bitches ain't getting that normal attention they get all day long when they leave their nigga go to work.
Right.
And niggas is hollering when they getting their coffee at Wild. She like, oh, damn, I do look good today. You feel me?
They so, not, so the not getting thing, that attention. So the thing that might have annoyed them at one point, they had missed it a little bit.
Right.
Do y'all miss it a little bit? Sure, Chelsea says they don't.
Say no.
People was doing it before. My timeline hasn't got filthier because, like, I kind of like weed. When I see like nasty shit come up, I'll literally unfollow people because I don't want to see like. I like the Spanish ones. They get that. I like those videos. Like,
okay.
Because it looks not too bad.
But. I don't like that dancing. I don't like that shit. That's just whack to me.
What? Twerking?
The Spanish
the booty,
dancing?
It be moving nice, but it's got to be a real butt. It can't be a fake butt. I don't want
to. Nah, I need African twerks.
Well, yeah. what it is.
They're kind of similar, bro. No,
they butt be little as shit. That shit like two knuckles.
He lying.
Nobody got time for that shit.
He lying.
That shit like a pre-K butt. Nobody don't got time for that
Spanish
shit.
Butt?
Yeah. That's some Spanish girls with fat asses, though.
They gotta know how to twerk like a black bitch, though.
You can buy one if you ain't got one.
That's what
that should be looking
nasty,
corny, though.
So
they,
like fake
butt. Fake butts
like
is corny
butt.
As shit to me.
Exactly. I'd rather a little butt.
That shit looks stupid.
Butt.
That shit, they like a toy.
Give me a little butt over the
like,
fake butt.
Like, you might as well fuck a fake butt. You might as well order a butt from the John, put that shit on your bed and bomb the fake butt. Fuck it. That's what you bombing in the first place, so fuck that. No.
Nah, but ain't it like a fat transfer? So it's like, it's kind of like it's dim. It's just that you're not fucking a fat butt. You fucking like. They chose it. They side. What's that called? They love handles and shit like that. You know what I mean?
If it don't look right.
That shit don't be looking right. It don't be looking right.
Your thigh is like this, and then your butt is like this. That's not cute. When you see a thigh that's like a chicken leg, and you see a butt that's like a watermelon.
I don't like that shit.
It looks gross.
I mean,
I don't know about to y'all.
You like fake butts?
Does it look gross?
I'm cool with a fake one.
Yeah.
I'm cool.
Even if the leg is mad skinny?
This is how I look at it. I don't believe that a butt or a breast could be fake. If I could squeeze it or suck on it, it's real. You feel what I'm saying?
And then when you squeeze it, that shit pop in your hand, then
exactly.
What?
As long as it exists, yo.
Yeah, now if it pop in my hand or something like that, then that's
like,
a little bit different.
I don't like fake titties. I need the fake titties to come from the armpits. I don't like the fake titties that, like that's old school. You know
yo,
what I mean?
Hold on. I'm going to stop you right there.
I'm just saying.
Because I'm going to tell you like this. With the rate of, silicone and plastic surgery and things like that, I would assume that in a room with three women in there, there has to be somebody in here with some fake body parts.
All right, so listen.
So hold on. Wait 1 second. Is there anybody in here by any chance that has...
Is there fake titties in the room?
Fake breasts, fake butt. So, hold on. So, I got a question. So I got to ask you. Hold on. I got to... No. This is my boy.
But they don't look fake. They look real.
No, they look real. That's not what I said.
I didn't even know.
No, I didn't say I didn't like fake titties.
Niggas be nigga fast as hell, right?
Listen to what I'm saying. What kind of...
I'm standing on all like fake ass, though.
No, listen. What kind of fake titties do you got? Do you got the fake titties where you got the slit underneath? Or do you got a fake titties where you can't see? Right, that's what I fuck with. I don't like the fake titties with the fucking slit underneath. I need
but
that shit to
up
be
like a balloon.
It need to feel as real as possible.
Okay.
You know what I mean? When I see the slit underneath, it's like, oh, this is a scar and shit. That's like something that's on my arm and shit. I don't
They're
fuck
nice
with
titties. I think they.
I mean,
but
no, I thought they was real. I ain't.
I like them some too.
I don't. I haven't seen the titties yet at all.
Okay.
I haven't seen them.
They look like good-ass fucking titties.
I mean, I don't see titties anywhere, my nigga. I'm going to keep it like that. I'm going to keep it a buck. I had something done to my eyes. I got something done to my eyes where I cannot see titties.
You heard me?
That do not belong to...
I don't know. What's the word?
I don't know what it is, but it's like a nigga dyslexic and he can't, he see shit fucked up. I just see a blur when I see any titties that's not, Veronica's titties.
I see a lot of titties.
Oh, you got the full-time horse blinders on, huh?
Yeah. I don't even know. Like, it just literally looked like blurs. Like, it looked like they wearing a name brand and I can't tell what that is. Is
they
that
look
Nike?
Like Japanese
pool. Is that Nike?
Nike or something, and they ain't had a sponsorship.
That's a good tip right
it's
there.
It's Japanese porn.
That's good tip.
Oh, okay. Japanese porn. Because obviously what we're talking about is like the chicks that's, online that's acting up. They acting new. But when I think about acting new, I got a question for y'all. Have you ever had a chick turn gay on you?
Temporarily or permanently?
I mean, I don't care. Whatever your situation was, did she turn gay on you? Like you used to fuck with John, and now she just like, nigga, I fuck with.
Fuck with bitches.
Yeah.
When you feel like shit, like, damn, maybe my dick wasn't good enough.
No.
Nah, never happened to you?
Nah, it did happen.
Oh, it did happen?
Yeah.
What happened in your situation, man?
She just started fucking with bitches after she stopped fucking with me. That was it was regular, though. She just ain't want to fuck with me. I was still hitting it, but...
Oh, so you see, you got the bomb drop because basically,
I see what's going on. Yeah,
so she ain't all the way turned. She just was like,
I don't want to deal with no new niggas.
Okay,
dealing with bitches.
She just added something to her resume.
Yeah.
What
yeah.
about you, Quill? What about your
friend? No, I ain't never had that.
Never had that happen, Quill.
So well, I ain't know. It's one of them.
So when you say when you bomb, they fucking with niggas for life. That's what you trying to basically say, Quill.
I guess so.
That's what you basically trying to say. You know what I'm saying? Like, he trying to talk heavy, basically. Like, nah, that shit would never happen to me. You know what I'm saying?
It didn't happen to him, though. She just wanted to fuck with girl. Like, more so he had some bad. She just wanted to do her.
Right.
There's some girls that switch up. They got to see what's up on the other side.
So it could have happened to you.
I don't know.
It could.
Just all of a sudden wake up and be like, you know what? I'm going to switch up today. Like, I think that's got to be a little bit of a buildup. I don't think you just wake up.
Some
and
girls
like,
just got fetishes. I feel like it's some girls that want to deal with a girl, but they scared
to do shit.
They scared to do new shit. Because you got girls
If you 40, you could wake up and do some shit like that.
Because you got girls that'll be in a relationship with somebody, and they probably want a threesome, but they won't.
Well, if you 40, you was thinking about it for 30 years.
Hey, we're scared to do it. Damn. True. You right. You right.
That's a fact, though.
Because you're like, damn, I'm 40. I did this, that. You know what? What's next?
And I feel like when girls be having girls' night, they be doing freak shit in that joint to each other.
They do. Know what?
That's what I feel like.
I agree.
They might be. Because this is the thing.
I don't give a fuck what they say.
Women do, like,
shit that we would consider, like, we could never do that. Like, they have, like, dildo parties and shit like that, where they be like, for real.
We never have a coochie party.
Right, right. They'll have, like, they have a person come through that's like a salesman. The salesman shows up, it's all kind of dildos, all types of dicks, you know what I'm saying, and toys, and they pull them joints out and be wilding out and talking about the ones they going to buy and pull their credit cards out and swipe and everything.
If you ever come through with some fucking toys, dog, I'm like, get the fuck out of my house,
word.
Bro.
Like, it's just like,
get out my house.
Else, let's have a pocket pussy party at the crib. Like, nobody's doing that.
Well,
you know
guys
what I'm saying?
Don't use them in general, so there'd be no reason for guys to have a party.
Nah, we just bring the bitches through.
I don't know if the guys have pocket...
Somebody
gave me a pocket pussy. Shit was crazy.
You used
it? I'm, you might as well beat your dick. I'm not playing with no pocket pussy. That's all. But you going through too much. You got to find the pocket pussy in your dresser and all that. When you could have just beat your dick up.
You looking like a whole nut trying to get your shit prepared and shit.
Now you asking nigga, yo, you saw my pocket pussy? I can't do
the
that.
The thing is, if he did see it, it's like, that's not. That's
now,
not
he did, now y'all done trained the pocket pussy. Nobody got time for that.
That's completely disgusting.
No, I feel you. I don't go to the pocket pussy. I just have one.
Oh, you just happen to have one.
Someone gave me a pocket pussy.
So where the pocket pussy at right now?
In my closet.
Hold on. So the pocket pussy's in your closet.
Mm-hmm.
So you admit to having a pocket pussy. You ever had a chick turn gay on you?
Okay.
And this the thing.
All right, listen.
I'm asking this question, but I know the answer. this so, my fucking boy right here.
So she didn't necessarily turn gay on me.
Okay.
She was already kind of wanting to be gay. And now she's, nigga, I don't want no work with shorty. Like, she brawlic.
Yeah.
She out here. She got guns.
Yeah. She's shooting shit right now.
She fucking, honestly, she might have a dick.
Yo.
Like, real
yo,
rap.
Nah.
But when I was fucking with her, she looked good. Yeah. But now...
That's so she on like dyke terms now.
No. She's a goon.
She got more hair on her legs than me.
Like, she'll take your chain off, Quill.
She buff.
She'll take your.
Yeah, that's
all. Yeah, but what I'm saying is, like,
she probably left.
She's like one of them full fledged. She probably left like the hormones and shit.
Yeah, yeah. She took the hormones, so she got.
She was crazy.
She got a mustache, everything, but she really out here gooning and everything. You.
It probably wasn't you. You know what I'm saying? She probably left because she probably wanted to fuck you.
No, it definitely wasn't me.
I'm saying she wanted to fuck you.
So she wanted to be like a
gay
nigga.
She wanted to fuck him.
Oh, shit.
But see, like, he probably wouldn't be with it, so she went to go do it to a girl.
Nah, bro.
No. Oh, I know. Yo, her mixtape.
But does she do a strap on? Is that what the dykes do? They like.
Yeah, they throw the straps on, I guess.
She probably got a dick now.
No.
Nah, it might not be able to get hard, but she got. I'm going to
tell you what she got. She got BDE. You know what BDE is? They call it big dick energy. She out here like she that nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? She's that nigga out here right now. You feel me? Look, her mixtape is crazy.
Oh, she raps too?
Listen, the mixtape is fire.
Teach about fire.
If she came in this room right now, nigga, right now, everybody be like, what's good?
Yeah.
He talking about what's
she'll
good.
Feel the energy. Like she look good. Like she looking to take niggas.
That's
like
crazy,
she go, like she gonna see you change. Shit, like she'd have probably jumped on the beat. Yeah. After you and shitted on you, you know what I'm saying? Because she
you know how
it.
Nigga be waiting for you to finish your last bar so you can just tag in.
Exactly.
Yeah. When I look at women, they butt don't stink, but her butt definitely stink now.
What?
I'm just saying, her butt stink.
Her butt stink.
So that's what makes you know that she made her fool.
So you don't think you could hit it again?
Hold on.
Fuck no. What?
All right, let me ask you this then, real quick. In this corona situation, right? Let's say this shit get real locked down, because y'all probably seeing this shit way later. This shit get real locked down. You can't get the no cheeks. You just stuck in the crib.
No way.
No cheeks whatsoever.
I don't even want you to finish this. No way.
Shorty come back around, say, listen, man, I'ma shave this down. You know what I really am. You know what I really am. I'ma shave this down. You already know what I was hitting for before. Can we get it popping?
But her voice 3 octaves lower though.
Her butt still stinks.
Oh, okay.
It still stinks. Got hair on that joint. I don't fuck with it.
Yeah. Yeah, she got bars, man. But like, speaking of motherfucking bars, like on some music shit, cause we got a real MC and shit in here. Mm-hmm. And I bet you this nigga rap too, man. Cause it's something about like comedian niggas or something rap, man. And he make music and shit. Yeah. Like, yeah, it's always rap? Something, man.
You mean? No, I ain't fucking used to rap.
Yeah, never rap before?
Rap, no.
I just figure
you sound, you make beats or something.
No. Nah, I just nah, I don't figure that, but I figure like everybody that do like comedy and shit, like niggas rap. Yeah. But like to you, Paulo, I want to pose this question: like, what is bars? Like, you know, people always talk about bars. After somebody spit something, niggas be like, oh, bars. What is bars to you? Because it's different to everybody.
I mean, it's different to everybody, but I think everybody don't really got a definition of it. Shit, to me, it's the art of putting words together and painting a picture with them words.
So when but you say also, painting, you talking about like is it the comparisons
it's,
or
it's the description, it's the colorful words that you use to say something regular. Mm-hmm. It's you know what I mean, similes and metaphors, like the technical wordplay and shit like that.
So if a nigga don't got the similes and metaphors, would you consider a person like a MC if he don't got no comparisons, no likes or as, he just he rhyme words good together, you know what I'm saying? So right. When he rap, everything is just like, you know, fossil fuel, brothel boobs, you know what I'm
not,
saying?
That's not bars to me. It ain't to me, it's just that's Dr. Seuss shit.
I don't consider that's Dr. how Seuss. They be hostile dudes. Yeah, you like the apostles do.
Nah, see,
rocket fuel.
It gotta be content. It gotta be content
so
in the
think,
words. You know what I'm saying?
Do you think when I think about that, I think like when Lil Wayne back in the day mixtapes, like he would just say the most basic stuff like yellow something school bus. Like they say something and they say the next thing that was the same exact thing. And then you have Biggie who was like a storyteller. So do you think Biggie and Lil Wayne are both, they got bars, or you think one is like a storyteller and that's like a whole different type of artist than someone who just like fabulous, just keeps spitting shit and has nothing to do with the next line and just keeps going?
We about to get in an argument.
Nah, that all go together. That all go together.
But it's two different types, but like, is it both bars?
Yeah, it's different types, but it all go together because, like, even Wayne, like, he got technical skill with his bars. It may not, everything ain't a story, but his skills is there. The technicalities of it, the wordplay, the way he flipped words and make it mean some, three different things with the double entendre, triple entendre, all that shit is in there. So yeah, his skills in that fab too. He just a punchline king, but yeah, that's bars.
And Biggie,
his punchline bars.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what
yep. And the thing is, let's remember this about Biggie. Biggie used to like find his way to the story, cause it would be like, you know, think Biggie pussy with fuck that. Like he would be kicking a different rap, and then it would turn into a story. You feel what I'm saying? Like he had to get warmed up with like random bars.
He was
bars.
Never off beat, ever.
Yeah.
He don't got one syllable that he ever spoke that was off beat. He one of the only niggas you could say that about. Nigga was never off.
What is Cam'ron?
He's a
what do
genius.
You consider that?
He's a fucking
yo,
genius.
Yo, but there's a meme going around right now.
Well, I see it.
I posted this meme and niggas start flooding in bars. And Cam'ron, it was a picture of Cam and it said, quarantine got your bitch on whorentine on the Florentine. She looked back at me, said, I want morentine.
Yo, that's my nigga, yo. He'd have did that.
He would have did that.
He'd have did that and then some, yo.
He would have did that. I like Cam, man. Was you a Cam fan?
No.
What'd he say? Gladiator.
How old are you,
bro? He gave a head and he had
24.
Gladiator, some shit.
Hold on, so
he 24.
So you missed that whole era.
Yeah, I want no Cam.
I woke up listening to
hey,
Cam
Ma,
today.
What's up?
So what was, hold on, so you just saying like you don't fuck with Cam as a rapper?
No.
Is it because he said computers beating? Is that no, I'm asking?
Nigga,
I'm
that beat was so hard he could have said anything on it.
But is that why?
No, that ain't why.
Do you wear pink?
No,
never wore pink.
No,
because he did put the pink on. He did make that.
I
pop
never wore pink.
They
though.
Really
I
had America did. Wearing that shit, yo. I had a pink low. I had
shirt,
a pink low in that
pants,
day.
None of that shit.
Okay, one more question. Not to interrupt you. What is baby? What do you think his type of rap is?
Baby like
Lil Baby.
Like what do you call that?
I mean, he don't even write his raps.
I think he says the same five words, like diamond on the pearl cluster. Like that's all he says.
Get it from the ground.
Get it from the ground.
I fuck with Birdman. Yo, I fuck with Birdman raps. And they are very repetitive.
Nah, they are. He ain't a rapper though, man.
What it is I think that he wrote or somebody wrote him one rap.
Yeah.
And then he throws the bars in the air and then raps it in different order.
Yeah.
So it's the same rap, but like this line came first and shit like that.
Yeah.
Like, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's Birdman.
But he sound like Quill sounded like extra mad when we talked about Cam'ron. Like, he just sounded like angry.
Cam was that nigga. You ain't fuck with Cam'ron?
Nah, I ain't fuck with Cam'ron.
You
don't
fuck, you ain't fuck with the Dipset at all?
You don't fuck with Dipset?
I fuck with Juelz Santana. I fucked it with Juelz.
Okay, so did he. Right. I'm going to keep it real. I'm going to put him out there. He thought he was Juelz Santana. No, listen.
Definitely part of Dipset.
Listen, this nigga thought he was... Some people know him as Joel. He thought he was Joel Santana.
Hold on, to clear this up, my middle name is Joel.
That's what I'm saying. Right. But he thought he was... I think his name was like Joel Bandana or some shit like that. And he was walking around like he was Joel's.
Niggas call me Els, but not for that reason, but it still gets...
He accepted it back then.
Yeah, I was talking like, with Joel Santana, though.
Proud to wear that moniker.
Nah, I mean, Els.
Back then, he was a young bull. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And they was super popular.
I did have a bandana. I did have a
bandana.
Red bandana. And I walked like Juelz in that one video.
He did. It. Yo, he used to walk around like Juelz, bro. He was really like, no. The nigga was really. He was Joel's bandana. Like, that's a fact. That's
what
super,
I'm calling you from now on.
That's a super fact. You know what I'm saying? But like, let's switch gears. Like, how do y'all think people feel right now? Like, right now, it's a bunch of people at home collecting a check for no reason. Like my girl got a full-time job, right? And right now, she be on, like, phone call duty. So mm-hmm. all she got to do is be at the crib, and just in case somebody called a phone, which they don't at all, she's getting a full paycheck. How do you think, like, essential workers feel right now being stuck at work at Walmart, at a grocery store, stocking shelves, knowing that motherfuckers is at home in quarantine, chilling?
They should have got a job that wasn't essential.
That was real Republican of you.
Damn.
That's not nice.
Damn.
That was a great answer.
Yeah.
You can't say they should have got a job, because what if somebody really enjoys their
job?
Listen, because
these
they
niggas
don't think
on
about
unemployment
quarantine.
Is getting that motherfucking
Who the fuck enjoys
bag?
Walmart?
They're getting that bag on unemployment.
Well,
they get unemployment.
How do we know they're not getting paid a little bit more?
No,
hopefully
not.
They is.
No,
hopefully they is.
No,
you don't know that. I think they should, and
they should
they
be getting hazard
are.
Pay.
No. What it
or
is is they absolutely should be getting hazard pay. I think their hazard pay in a lot of these stores is $2. It's some bullshit.
I think it's like $2.
It's some bullshit. And on, like we joking and playing, but in reality, niggas should be getting paid something respectful if they gonna go out there and make... Because at the end of the day, we know that these companies is making more money than they ever made before. We going out there... Truthfully, we going to the store buying more groceries than we ever bought. We sitting in a crib bored, eating the shit faster than we normally would. Like,
and then go buy the shit again.
I'm looking like, I spent $900 on
That's
groceries this
they
month. Like, that don't make sense.
They got a stimulus check to get that shit right back.
I don't know anybody.
Gonna stimulate the economy.
I don't know anybody on unemployment, but supposedly they getting an extra $600 on their unemployment every fucking week. So
that's
listen,
a fact.
I want to be on Wait, unemployment.
They
getting
what?
They getting
an extra $600 on top of it. So like my cousin, he's on partial unemployment, right? So he actually still go to work and get bread. Whatever, the system is so busy that they basically give you full unemployment when you want partial unemployment, so he make $900 extra a week. He loving this shit.
Like, yeah, that's like, full time, and I think I haven't got my unemployment yet, hasn't been through, but I think I'm gonna make more now than my regular job, my regular full time job with benefits and everything. So it's kind of like, yeah, that's good, but then when people got to go back to work, it's like, well, why can't I make that check? And I don't think it's anything wrong with people that's been working and then now they're just home. I don't think it's money for no reason. I think you put work in, you put time in, and, you know, it's kind of like a break for everyone, but it's good to get that money and be able to have some time for yourself, because what's it for? What do you pay taxes for? What does all your money go for times like this when you got to get that money back, when you need to have food to feed yourself, to feed your family, to feed whoever the hell, your pets, whatever the hell it is. That's what you work for, to have that kind of fallback in circumstances like this. So
yeah,
and lay I think, me the not fuck off.
Huh?
Lay me the fuck off. I want to chill at the crib and do fun shit by myself or with my niggas.
And your pocket pussy.
And his
pocket pussy in the closet.
And his pocket pussy in the closet. Also, like,
preferably
people,
a mold.
People, possibly, if you can. Well, everybody should be able to. Man, if you come out of this quarantine fatter, that's on you. Get in shape. Put your time into something else in your business.
Most people actually got more money because they're not out running it to the movie theater.
Right.
They can't hit the bar. They can't buy bottle service. Right. Like,
can't even go to Macy's.
Make this shit a level up. You know what I'm saying? Have you been working on like more skits or more shit? Or it didn't matter to you because you was already getting your bread just on the skit shit.
Yeah, so I'm doing the same shit for you. Just can't go nowhere fun. That's the only boring part of the shit. Like, you can't even do shit.
Right.
But on some shit, if you is making money right now, this is the best time to save money. So like, you can't go to no fucking stores and buy shit. So it's like, what are you spending money on besides food?
Yeah, when you go out, you only, like, you go out to the store, right? Like, if you go out to the store, I know you got a girl right now, but you in a grocery store.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody got mask on.
Right.
Everybody walking around with the mask.
Right.
So you see a joint with a mask on.
Uh-huh.
That ass is stupid.
Right.
Dumb.
Okay.
Dumb. The titties.
I just went through this shit.
The titties is like whatever y'all said these titties look like that I can't see.
Yeah, we don't. Me and you.
Me and you both can't see.
I forgot to say that when you said it.
Right. They digital. My Jones is a digital scramble like prism when you try. You don't even know nothing about
that. I see what you're saying now.
Oh, you like colorblind, but with titties.
I see them titties, girl.
Yeah. Right. Right. So you see a chick out there with this whole social distancing, because I heard some shit, bro, where they said we might have to practice social distancing till 2022. How does a nigga see a chick out and about and holler when you see something?
Yo, I just went through that shit, though. I seen something nice at the juice bar, too.
Yeah, if I was her at the mouth juice was bar. Covered, how you know she got teeth?
So you got back? So you saying, like, how
I,
would
I
you
don't
come
know.
At her?
I just said, I said I seen something nice. Yeah.
Like, how you gonna come at her if when you step up 6 feet?
I just
feet?
Had to take the L.
Hold up. We can't hear you. Step up. Step up.
Okay.
I got an idea, though. You tell Shorty, step back 6 more feet. Pull that thing down. Oh, you all right. You can come with me.
So who going for that right now? So
ain't nobody trying to say
that. Listen, they going, listen, you going to get that.
Like, yo, what's your Instagram?
Without the mask going, it ain't
that easy. Listen, first off, you see how chicks get mad at niggas for whack game?
Right.
Yeah. We just got real bad pointers. That is, I promise you, this will not work for any of y'all niggas.
She going to curse you the fuck out.
Right. You better look like, I don't know, you better look like some other type nigga. I don't know what type of nigga you got to look like.
On.
I mean, if you get 1%, it might work on her. She made it up. I don't know. Yeah.
You gotta be like,
I'm gonna do some jail
shit. Yeah, she gonna
shit.
Be the test drive.
You know how back in the day you was just doing some sign language and shit?
Yeah.
Big C's. Yeah,
up to the window and everything.
I'm gonna be like, hey,
so,
what's up,
so,
bitch?
Nah, so when you saw something, what you ran into, bro?
I mean, I just had to take the L, man. I just had to take the L. I was like, what I'm gonna do? Pull my mask off and be like, you? Like,
you can say you. Do the mask.
You got pulled up in the whip and beat the horn.
I was in the whip. I rolled the window down.
No, not you.
If you're over 30 years old, you're going, yerp.
Over 30?
Yes. Okay. No, over 28. Ain't no all right. More yerping.
All right.
Hold on. What happened?
I feel like
you got to roll the window down.
I feel like you got to say yerp, though.
If I hear yerp, you're automatically a young bull.
Exactly. You know I'm fucking young. A nigga be like, yo, excuse me, sweetie. Honey, sugar, can I tell? He old as shit.
Yeah, he on some other tight time.
Sugar crazy.
Nigga like 45.
That means he going to take care of you. If he say yerp, he ain't got no money.
I know a lot of niggas that say yerp that got a bunch of money. I don't want to say yerp before fucking
money in his pocket, but no money in bank. All right,
but you got
the long run.
You got the old head talking about, excuse me, sugar, and he live in a fucking apartment by himself, and he got three ex wives and two of his kids. He got fucking the fucking check they get old people.
SSI,
Social Security,
and he still got young kids in college. So what the fuck he gonna do for you?
If you say yerp, I think about empty pockets, no long run.
All right, say nigga be like yerp, and he show you his money this time. Didn't he?
I'd be like, okay, that's all you got.
Oh man,
yo, he got yerp on a bike. I'm like,
hey yo,
yeah.
This is time of OnlyFans. If I show some bitches some money, they're gonna be
surprised what they do for some of them coins.
Listen, OnlyFans is completely popping on another level right now. You know what I'm saying?
OnlyFans crazy on some shit. It was a girl I went to school with. She on her. I lost it. What is this bitch doing on OnlyFans right now? I start calling motherfuckers. I'm like, yo, she is on OnlyFans right now. I'm telling y'all.
So let me ask you this.
Who trying to make some fucking money right now?
I'm going to look you dead in the eyes and the camera is right on you, so you ain't going to be able to lie. Did you subscribe?
Fuck no. No. No, I'm not subscribing.
You didn't subscribe?
Mm-mm. I can't subscribe. I'm cool.
I'm just saying, anybody trying to do some OnlyFans, I got y'all. You know what I mean? We can set it all up.
He's basically trying to pick somebody.
Let's get some money.
He wants somebody that is completely computer illiterate, that don't know nothing.
Nah, even if you're not. Like, if you need somebody to rock out with for more content, come on, let's get some money.
Mm.
He's trying to be a
he won 20%.
He's trying to be a porn star.
Yeah, whatever the fuck it is. You clean, you know what I mean? Let's get it. You know what I mean?
Trying
to, you know what I mean? I'm going to cover my face, you know what I mean? I don't want nobody to see me, but you know what I mean?
I ain't going to lie. That's some nuts shit, though.
No, it's not.
Niggas really subscribe? Nah, I'm talking about niggas really subscribing.
I don't give a fuck about the niggas subscribing. I'm trying to make the money.
Some niggas need they porn to be a little bit more personal, a little bit more like I got them comic books back there, and some comic books, there's only a certain amount that exists. Niggas want to know, like, with they porn, them niggas that's really into it, they want to know only 166 other niggas seen this footage. You know what I'm saying? It probably just helped they beat off. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, it's real rare. You feel what I'm saying?
I think people like they're going to be like, oh, he got a twin bed. I fuck with that. I'm like, oh, all right.
What?
Some people might fuck with twin beds.
Hold on, wait.
Some people might fuck with twin beds. Yeah. So what? That nigga, when you go on fucking Pornhub, you go on Pornhub, niggas is crazy, bro.
So like, you saying you go to Pornhub and look up twin bed?
I don't, but some people might.
I feel like he did.
And if they look up twin bed, you're saying they'll find you?
He pop it right up.
Hold on, wait. Hold on, you're saying if they look up twin bed,
let's get this money.
They'll find you.
Same way people like four fucking feet porn, they going like twin bed.
So basically, what he's saying is he got a twin bed. He lay on the twin bed. Am I wrong or right?
That shit got a weight capacity.
Slide to the closet, pocket pussy time on the twin.
Yo, wait. This is the thing. I'm putting him out there. It definitely has a weight capacity.
On the twin, yeah.
Because this nigga broke. Yo, I go to this nigga crib, right? I go in this nigga room. I see, like, it's not 2x4s. I don't know what it would be, but it's a bunch of, like, basically, like, 2x4s all snapped. Like, a bunch of them snapped all over the floor. Shit. This nigga must have been going ham because he broke this
shit. My bad. High as shit right now because I had to put one of those, what's that shit called?
Bed risers?
How you put a mattress? No, you put a mattress and then what's underneath?
A box spring.
Yeah.
I had to put a box spring on top, basically on top of a box spring.
Because
he's basically on top of a box.
So you double box springed up. That's what you're saying.
Because I broke that joint.
Got the double bubble.
You know,
and none of the chicks don't have no problem with it. They just like
they don't know nothing about it. They don't even know it's weird.
They giving up the box on the box spring. That's just how it go down. They don't give a fuck.
Let's get to that.
Mm. Well, yo, one more thing I wanted to talk about. Movies. I wanted to talk about movie pet peeves. What's something that you see in a movie or see in movies in general that piss you the fuck off when you see it, God?
I got a bunch of ideas.
When they be having sex, they just show the butt. Like, nobody want to see nobody fucking butt. What's going on? Or they try to flip to another scene, come back, they sweating and done. Which we didn't see them fuck. What just happened?
Hold on. So with
it's
Quill,
a movie, not
you know
what
I'm talking about? Quill
ain't important, but you not about to let us see them kiss, work up to the sex, then just get off their scene and come back.
No. This is the crazy part about all of this. One of my major pet peeves is the opposite of him.
What?
I actually hate sex scenes in movies, bro.
Mm-hmm, me too.
Every bitch in the movie got the best pussy in the world. Nigga be in and out of that shit.
The reason why I think the sex scenes is just them being lazy and just trying to fill up time in the budget. Like if I'm watching some shit like Game of Thrones, I want to see some drag. I'm a geek and shit. I want to see some dragons or some fucking dwarves and midgets, some wizards and some shit. You know what I mean? I don't want to see you fucking, you know what I'm saying? I got Pornhub for that. You know what I'm saying? So when they go to a long ass fuck scene, I'll be like, oh, these niggas is trying to save bread. Like, that's what they really trying to do now.
That Jones be hard. Like, I ain't gonna hold you. You saw Love and Basketball?
Yeah, I
love it. Remember when he took her virginity?
Yeah.
That shit was thorough. That shit was a real joint.
No, my first sex scene that was weird. That shit did feel official. You ever see Pumpkinhead?
Whoa. Your first what?
The sex scene I remember seeing on video that I thought was really, like, weird. Y'all remember Pumpkinhead, the movie Pumpkinhead?
I don't.
Do you remember Eminem? What's the Eminem movie? 8 Mile?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That, like, I remember watching that and being like, this is kind of awkward. That was that age when you're like, like, this sex scene's kind of weird.
All I remember is why Eminem bust off in 2 seconds. Like, he held the joint up in the air and just squirted in there.
Every motherfucking bitch in the movie got the best pussy in the world.
And I'm going to tell you this another thing. People in movies do not wear condoms. I promise you. Because in every movie, a chick
meet... But they don't be really doing it.
Listen, no, I'm just saying the actual characters.
About what?
What's the joint with my nigga Alan Payne and Jada Pinkett back in the day shit?
Lyric. Jason's Lyric. Nah, this is what happens in a movie. A chick walk up to a nigga on a motherfucking, and while he at a bar, she say something slick to him and everything. Let's get out of here.
They get out of here. They walk in the crib. They knock the lamps over and shit. They always knock the lamp over, push the door behind them shut.
It's all passionate.
And they jump in, and they never, nobody grabs yondums, guy. No, nobody.
Don't. They don't.
It made me start thinking, because most of these is white people, and I'll be starting to think white people don't wear yondums, guy.
They don't.
I don't think they wear them, guy. I think they just as guilty as some of us. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I actually don't fuck with them type Jones. But my pet peeve in movies is this.
Hold up.
You got to buy it there.
Do white people wear condoms?
You got to buy it there. Oh, nah, he's trying to get up out of there.
Yo, you heard it here first. You heard it here first. She said, nigga, listen.
Whatever comes first.
Yeah, I guess so.
All right, let's get to that.
My pet peeve in movies, bro, is really got to do with like our people. Got to do with black people and shit, man. I hate when I watch movies and the movie's not made by black people. And they make black people related to each other that would never be related. Like, two light-skinned, mom and dad, dark-ass son. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, like, stop. Yo, like, I'm going to tell y'all right now. Like, yo, stop doing that shit, bro. Like, we about to protest. Like, stop doing that shit. Like, because I be thinking, y'all doing that on purpose. Like, if you see a nigga and he got a quill hair, do not get a kid to play him in a movie and this nigga light skin with the curly Albie like short joint, yo. I hate that shit, bro.
That's how they
bro.
Did Michael Jackson with the when the first nigga did the Michael Jackson shit.
Yeah, like, I be watching certain shit. Like I fuck with All American. I don't know if y'all ever watched
that.
That shit is great.
No, that's a good movie.
It's a great show. Yeah, great show. But then it be sometimes, man, they show a person when they a little kid or something. You be like, that's supposed to be him, God.
Right. Some whole.
Come on, God. That's not him. That nigga Puerto Rican, God.
Right.
Listen. I get why my son light skinned, and I still be like, why this nigga light skinned? He need to be a little darker.
He need to be a little
mocha.
Yeah, like,
why
son,
he not mocha?
Movies wouldn't give a fuck. They would just make your son white because, right, like, movies always act like motherfucking J-Lo white.
Right.
They just give her a white dad.
That's weird. No, right. I hate all J-Lo movies because of that.
Right.
It's like, yo, this could be a good movie, but it's like, why is all her dads Italian?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
There's something wrong with that shit, dog.
No, I'm ringing a bell. Yeah, I see. I think it's time.
Yeah, it's almost
time.
The
wheel.
Yeah, let's see what's up with this spinning wheel, John. See what we land on.
I'm hoping for a break because I like that ass. I like that ass.
She just wants people to spend money. I wonder if Quill got any dollars on him or he over here. He over here with empty pockets.
I got a fucking mask in my pocket.
Throw a mask on ass.
Cash up.
Let's see what we got right here on this twerk. Let's see on this wheel break.
Oh, damn.
Would you rather have smart, ugly kids? Like, I'm talking about these kids is ugly as shit, but they smart. Or dumb, beautiful kids. Like, these kids is gorgeous, but your son, this nigga can't count. This nigga's an idiot. Would you rather have, Quill? Like, this nigga's ugly. It's going to be hard games when it comes time.
I'm going to fucking smart, ugly. Fuck it.
Yeah, so this,
because if you think about it, his little smart ass going to get some money. That's all the money gonna bring everything else.
So the pain that he gotta go
through, pocket pussy.
So the pain that he gotta go through when he a kid, like the fact that he can't go to the school dance.
He gonna be cool because he gonna be on honor roll and shit like that. All the principals gonna like him. He always gonna be talked about. But the kids might bust on him and shit like that. Walking home from school, he might fight a little bit.
But I rather Quasimodo.
You gonna have a dumb, handsome son. He be done got set up some fucking where. He be done did some dumb ass. Your daughter gonna be pregnant because she's stupid as shit, so she just let anybody do
but shit. Your daughter might get an NFL nigga.
She might.
Because there's a lot of bitches that are dumb bitches with some NFL niggas. Let's keep it real. Right? Nigga, they might, listen, you might have three daughters and start your own Kardashian, you know what I'm saying? Like empire, nigga. What you talking about? Because I'm talking about beautiful. Like, people gonna see them and be like, oh my God.
And then they gonna talk to him like, what the fuck? Cause they ain't gonna know what they talk about. So ain't nobody got time for that shit.
What about you, Els?
Now they got X shy when you go to family reunions and shit.
I was about to answer this.
Yeah, that's Jason.
I was about to answer this and then I thought about it. My son's pretty fucking beautiful. So I don't wanna sit here and say beautiful kids and then he not dumb. And then
so
I want to say,
out.
I don't want to say dumb kid. I got kids, so he beautiful. I'm bowing out.
Not counting him. We call him, told him about you make
if
another
you,
one.
You had another one, and it was even smart.
It's like this. Let's just say by accident, you and the joint that got mixtapes now. You got her
dumb.
Pregnant.
I want that nigga dumb. I want that. No, not dumb. I want him smart as shit. I want him to be ugly.
What about you, Paolo? We got two uglies, man.
Yeah, shit, fuck it. Give me the pretty kid, man.
Word?
Yeah, it don't matter today. Anyway, everybody dumb. For real, these niggas is dumb. These bitches is pouring milk down the crack of their ass.
Yeah.
For the internet.
2%?
Yeah. Are you a little bit jealous?
If they look good, it's lit.
Almond milk?
Huh?
Almond milk.
It don't even matter.
Are you a little bit jealous that we get the bad end of the stick? Like, niggas, we can't just do shit like that to get over. Like,
nah, what's crazy is the bitches that say you thirsty if you watching that shit.
And they
doing it for what?
For the thirst.
My point.
Yeah,
y'all
know
hit
what?
Girls like
give me,
that.
Give me that pretty kid, man.
They'll shake their ass, and then you'll DM them, and they'll be like, what you want? Bitch, you just shake your ass. Fuck, you like I'm DMing
it's
you
like,
for?
It's like the Dave Chappelle skit back in the day when he was like, a bitch should be presenting themselves away. If you approach them like that, she get mad. He like, that's like, I got a cop uniform on,
right.
And a bitch come running up talking about, officer, this just happened or some shit. He be like, why the fuck are you telling me?
You got
the fucking uniform you wearing.
You got the uniform on, God. You know what I'm saying?
I feel like
how girls dress, that's what attracts certain niggas. I'm going to say that. Yeah. And the girl might not even be no nasty joint. That just might be her, like, that's how she dressed.
It's a whole nother conversation.
Yeah.
I want to comment on this fucking bad. No, I'm going to hold my
No, you can't, because this the thing.
I like nasty girls. I don't give a fuck.
I can't really judge. I can't judge chicks by shit like that because one of the worst whores I ever met was in church, my God.
True indeed. The worst ones be the pastor's daughter.
Like a devious joint, a joint that let a whole niggas run train on her and then said she got raped in the whole nine. And I knew, like, no, I know you let them niggas run trains. They ran train the whole team. Football team.
None of my business.
Yeah, pastor children be the worst, yo.
None of my business.
Yeah, then because sometimes they gotta really get right with God. Like, you don't be feeling like you gotta get so right because you ain't did nothing that's crazy, but they did some other shit. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? It's wild. But yo, for everybody, man, at home, man, please stay safe. Shout out to all the non-essential workers, you know what I'm saying, that's sitting at home right now, chilling, you know what I mean? And then a special shout out to the essential workers that really don't even know how this shit felt for niggas to be chilling at the crib and shit, because you still in there busting your ass every day, getting your extra $2. Well, I'm going to just put this, you know, out there. I believe you should have got way more than that, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? From the motherfucking rip, you know what I'm saying? You deserve more. Y'all niggas is out there being heroes and standing in the midst of this shit. And I just want to salute y'all, man. You know what I mean? For myself, for Funny Boy Quill, for Leonardo Vega.
Thank you.
Know what I'm saying? For Apollo, who's part of a different lineage. Like, I don't even know who my grandpop really is and shit like this. This nigga know his grandpop's a legend. I'm still, like, we on some. I'm on
my,
some ancestry.
My grandpop a legend too. He do crack.
Listen, my grandma, I'm just going to leave y'all with this. I did the ancestry.com. My grandmom got some explaining to do, God. and we out right now, man. Peace.
Don't be too selfish to share information with other people. It's enough out here for everybody, for real, for real. Like, I actually remember back in, like, 2007 when I was trying to really get into photography, and I was just shooting outdoors and everything like that, because I didn't know how to do, like, studio lighting or nothing like that. And I had bigger photographers, whether it be in Philly or New York, and they would hit me up sometimes, but what they would ask me about my pictures, they would ask for the models. You know what I mean? Oh, what's up with that girl? I would love to shoot her. This, that, and the third. And of course, like, I'm not going to let that model miss out on the opportunity. So I send them that, you know, their way. But when I would ask any of those photographers any questions on improving my craft or just what to have, I would, you know, what, like, equipment to buy, I'd tell them, listen, man, I'm a regular guy. I work a regular job. I don't make any money. I really can't afford to buy the wrong lighting, you know, one time. I need to know what can you point me in some kind of direction where to go? And dudes would literally tell me, like, oh, I can't really tell you which way. There's so many options. You got to kind of find your own way in this. And it was really a way of blocking another person because they feel like they don't want to create more competition. And I ran into that over and over again. They will want to use the same models as you. They will ask you about stuff like that, but they didn't want to help a person out. Like, it's not enough money for everybody to make. And I want to shout out Jason Hudson because that was the only dude that was like, yo, check this out. I'm going to send you this link. You could grab one of these setups right here. You'll be good to go. I went, set up photo shoot, shot with that stuff, sent it over to him. He said, oh, you on your way. And that was it. It don't take much. Don't be afraid to share information with other people. I'm not telling you that if you like Burger King and you got a secret sauce to give away your secret ingredient. That's not what I'm saying. But if you are... you ask any photographer that shoots at SFX Studios, I don't care if it's Kiara Maxwell, I don't care if it's Flicks by Scott, A-Rod, Mom, you know, Bueller, Mark Bueller, whoever, James Johnson from the beginning, I'll show you everything. I'll show you. You want to know how I accomplished this lighting? I'll show you. Because there is room for everybody. There is different circles of people for them to sell to. And that don't matter whether it was a hot dog stand or whatever. You see how many hot dog stands there is, right? When you walk in like block to block. Because there's a lot of people to sell to. Do not be afraid to share information with others. Don't be too selfish to share information with others.